Disclaimer, this video is just for fun. I do not think any of these characters are likely, nor do I want them in, or think they should be in. I respect and am well aware of Sakurai's video game characters only rule. This is simply a what if video, if he were to break the rule. What's up guys, Leopold the Brave here, and Super Smash Bros. Ultimate is almost here, just a couple more months, and there's been tons of speculation from lots of different people about what kind of characters could be added in. First parties, third parties, I did a video on that, and Echo Fighters. Some of the new characters Sakurai added break some rules that he previously had, for example, Ridley being too big. So what would happen if he broke another rule this time around? Allowing non-video game characters to get in. I've put together a list of 5 fighters that would make the most sense if Sakurai decided to break this rule with them. And this is in no particular order. Number 1 is just as good as number 5. Number 4 is just as good as number 3. Let's begin. Number 1 is the one and only Wreck-It Ralph. At first, Super Smash Bros. Was a celebration of Nintendo, but as more guest stars rolled around, it became a celebration of video games as a whole. So, if Sakurai were to take the next step and break the rule, he'd obviously choose someone who embodies this celebration of video games, and that is none other than Wreck-It Ralph. He had a hit movie with another one on the way just in time for Smash Ultimate. Wreck-It Ralph featured tons of Nintendo characters and characters from other companies. Not to mention, he did have his own game on Nintendo consoles, and has made some appearances in big games, whether it be his summon cameo in Kingdom Hearts 3, or his appearance in Sonic and Sega All-Stars Racing Transformed. So overall, Wreck-It Ralph just seems like a no-brainer when it comes to adding movie characters to Smash. If Sakurai allowed this, there's only one thing I can think of that would get in his way. Number 2. Mickey Mouse is number 2. Wreck-It Ralph is a Disney character. So is Mickey. If any Disney character is going to get a rep first in Smash, it's going to be Mickey Mouse. He's had a massive abundance of games on Nintendo systems, and plenty of them are exclusive. With Mickey's rich and detailed history, there'd be tons of stuff to pull from for a moveset. He could use some magic from the Sorcerer's Apprentice, a Keyblade from Kingdom Hearts if Sora were to also make it in, paint and thinner from Epic Mickey, or Toodles from Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. My brothers watched that a lot. Yeah. Not me. My brothers. Yeah. If Sakurai were to break this rule with the mindset of representing animation instead of specifically animation about video games, then Mickey Mouse is definitely the first thing that would come to his mind. But considering how Disney got in the way of Marvel and other companies during the production of Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite, I'm not sure I'd want them to mess with Smash Brothers. Number 3 is Popeye the Sailor Man. Now, if you're a true Nintendo enthusiast, or if you just have no life and watch too many video game facts videos, you'd know that Donkey Kong was originally planned to be a Popeye the Sailor Man game. Aside from that though, Popeye has actually had plenty of games on Nintendo systems, mainly the classic ones, even as far back as the Game & Watch. He also has a massive legacy in animation, so he'd be a great rep for Nintendo to fall back on if they couldn't get their hands on Mickey Mouse. Plus, Popeye's a fighter. His cartoons are full of all kinds of zany hand-to-hand combat. He'd have an incredibly unique, wacky, and interesting moveset based around cartoon logic. So with his history in animation, and what he could have been for Nintendo if he had taken Mario's role in Donkey Kong, Popeye would make an excellent choice for a non-video game character in Smash Ultimate. At number 4, we've got Captain N the Game Master. Now, Popeye is a fantastic choice when it comes to cartoons that have to do with Nintendo, but this cartoon literally is Nintendo. Now, I've never seen Captain N, so the protagonist could have a completely different name and Captain N could just be the name of the show, but I'll just keep calling him Captain N. Now, this dude is the only one of his gang missing out on all the action. We've already got Pit, we've got Mega Man, we've got Simon Belmont, and we've got Princess Peach. Even his weapon, the Zapper, has some representation thanks to Duck Hunt Dog. So come on, Captain N is literally the last thing missing. Speaking of Duck Hunt Dog though, Sakurai likes to throw in characters that will confuse us, like Game & Watch, Rob, and of course Duck Hunt Dog. And Wii Fit Trainer, I guess. I don't know, I feel like I'm the only one who doesn't think she's an oddball choice. Wii Fit was doing really well and she was relevant at the time. But anyways, we're still waiting on that what the heck character for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. And Captain N would certainly be a surprise. Number 5. Son Goku. Up, 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 remember the disclaimer at the beginning of the video. This is just for fun. But come on, guys, he's in the thumbnail. You knew what you were getting into. Plus, it's Goku. You expected him to be here, didn't you? Doesn't that say a lot about his chances? Realistically, if Sakurai ever did decide to break the rule of non-video game characters not being allowed in Smash, there is no doubt that Goku is the first character he'd head for. Despite what a lot of people think, he's not one of the meme choices like Shrek or SpongeBob. Tons of people legitimately want Goku in. Even top players and popular Smash tubers acknowledge how cool it'd be to see Goku in and how much they'd love to see him in despite how absurd it may seem. Plus, it'd be a lot easier than you guys think. Bandai Namco is helping with production on Ultimate, and they have produced some of the most popular Dragon Ball games, like FighterZ, which is coming soon to the Switch, just in time for Ultimate. With the amount of popular Dragon Ball games that are out there, the support from Bandai Namco, and the massive outcry from fans all over the place, Goku seems like the most obvious choice if Sakurai broke this rule.